you so much. Wow, what a warm welcome. And that's actually also what I wanted to start with, because I was here a couple of months ago for the first time. Les invited me to come over, it's been said before. And that was tremendous, you know. There was so much hospitality of the team, and it was such a warm welcome that it was an easy decision, after all, to choose Gainesville as our second home. And now we even have the key to our second home, which of course is fantastic. So now we need to get in. Yeah. Well, today actually is a very important day in Europe, as you all know. There's a Brexit today, so everybody's a little bit disappointed. The stock markets, they go down. So we're ready to send some good news back to Europe about us getting started here in Gainesville. Hopefully that will give a big smile on everybody's faces again in Europe. At least, yeah, that's what we hope. I think it's good to tell you a little bit of a story to get a better understanding of who we are as a company, where we come from, because here in the back is also Arnoud. Arnoud is my university friend. We met in 1996 in a small town in the Netherlands. And actually at that time we became friends. And after that university time, we both went our own ways and we came back together in the year 2005. So that's almost 11 years ago. So that means that in a couple of weeks, we will celebrate our 11th anniversary. And the reason why we came back together is because my father stopped working at Genesis. He used to be the CEO at Genesis, which was the number one call center software vendor in the world at that time. And he had the opportunity to go for a big job in Paris. But what he decided to do, and it's also in this book, it's been said before, he decided to build the company Vanart Group. And that's where we all came together. So we were sitting down, the three of us, and making a plan on how we would achieve our dreams, right? Because that's what you need to have if you want to achieve something beautiful in life. And the role that my father has played in that time has been really interesting, because he used to be our mentor, our coach, but sometimes also the devil's advocate. So we've seen him in many, many, many roles in our almost 11 years that we are working together with him. But we are really grateful that he is a part of our organization, part of our team, and has such a huge impact as the founder of the company because of all his knowledge. At the same time, Arnoud and I had to get started, because what we did is we bought a company that went into bankruptcy. We bought it and we had to turn it around. We didn't have much time, so it had to go fast. And that's what we started doing. And I don't know if anybody has any experience in the call center world, but if you work in the call center world, you really have to understand what it means to talk to the customer. If you don't understand that feeling, then you don't have a chance at all. So what we decided to do from day one is put on the headset and work together with the 26 people that were in the acquisition that we did. And it created an atmosphere and an energy and a flow in the team that was incredible. It was beautiful to see what happened, because all these people were really disappointed. They were scared that they lost their jobs. They didn't know what was going to happen. Two of those crazy young guys walked in, and then my father also joined the team, and he was a former top executive in the US. So these people, they really thought, what's going to happen? Is this going to be okay? And what happened was actually really beautiful. We all came together. We put down some great results. And from that moment on, we knew that we could make the difference if the people would have the central position in our organization. And that's something that we never lost before. And a lot of things happened, by the way, in all these years that we have been working together, because at the time that we started in the call center industry, that was the time of telemarketing in Europe. Huge, all those outbound campaigns, you know, disturbing you all during dinner and offering you propositions for telcos or utility organizations, stuff like that, calls like that. And that's not really what we thought could be the big value or the added value that we wanted to deliver to the market. So we said we have to do something differently. And by talking to our people and talking to our prospects and clients, we understood that we had to create the value for loyalty. And at that time, the retention program started, so we were focusing on keeping the customers in. And if you keep the customers in, you start to understand how important service is, real service delivery out of a, from a, for a brand, for companies. And that actually picked up pretty well because we started growing and very, very fast, and we were very successful in our home market. And we also had another ambition. We wanted to grow, but we didn't want to grow with external money. So we wanted to grow with the money that we earned ourselves. And until today, none of the venture capitalists is part of our organization. Everything that we built is built based on the margin that we made ourselves. So that's the investment that we do in our own organization. And the growth actually took off, and it was fantastic to see. And after a couple of years, we said to each other, wow, we now have quite a large organization, but it's all focused on the services part. And what we really think could be the big differentiator in the future would be technology. So the combination of technology and people. And we all live, as you know, in the digital age. I don't think there's anybody in this room today that doesn't have a smartphone or a mobile phone. Probably everybody would have one, right? So we're in the middle of a digital age, and everybody communicates in a totally different way. And this is where we come to our proposition, and it's described poorly on our website. I agree, we will launch a new website somewhere soon. I think it was the 1st of September. But this is what it's all about. It's not the company anymore that is in control of the conversations with the customers. The customer is in control of each conversation with the brand. And that is something the companies need help with. And we are then the right partner to help them doing that. So we don't work with agents or contact center reps. We work with people that represent the brand. So we work with brand representatives, and they really understand how to communicate via each channel that the brand has to offer, because otherwise the customer will leave, and they really understand how to communicate via all these channels. So that maybe is a more easy way to tell what we are doing. For us, today actually is extremely exciting. I told you how we got started. This is a new chapter of our book that we are writing. We always call it, Arnold and I, we always call it the journey that we're in together, and we never know where it will end. But this is a new chapter, and it really makes us proud to be a human engagement company. I explained to you where it came from, a human engagement company that has been welcomed this way, right? So this is for us absolutely fantastic that we can join the Gainesville community, that we are here today with all these people. So. And what's really important, I really would like to thank all the people that had a huge impact on the couple of days that we spent over here, because they were in split trips that we experienced all that hospitality. I would really ask for a huge applause for all the people that helped us during those days, because they made a great impact on this decision. There's so much more to tell, but I don't want to, you know, talk too long to all of you. I see that the picture is back on the screen, and that gives you a little bit of a view of what Rotterdam looks like. So if everybody ever wants to visit the Netherlands, please let us know. You're more than welcome. We will show you around Rotterdam. We will show you around our campus. You know our second home, right, after today. But this is where everything got started since 2005. This is a famous bridge, the Erasmus Bridge. And we are very proud of that beautiful city. And I know that there are many people right now waiting for our response on how today went over here, because it's an important day also for the 1,000 people that work for us in our other offices in Europe, and even also in China, even though they're already asleep, I would say. 12 hours later, right? It's a time difference. Yeah, I prepared a couple of other slides, but maybe it's better to skip. Yeah, I think we can now better move towards to the movie. We would like to show you a small video that gives some explanation. After that, I come back for just only 30 seconds. Thank you. The books have been mentioned before. This is the first book. It's called Attitude. The name Ad comes back again. That's the first name of my father, the founder of our company. And there's a book written about his life. And the reason why this book was given to him originally is because he's a great storyteller. It's unbelievable. And when when he keeps on telling stories, at a certain time you start to worry, because what will happen after 20 or 30 years when Otto's not in the office every day anymore, right? Somebody needs to tell those stories. And then we made the decision, we should put all these stories in a book and let everybody that works for the Van Aert Group read this book, because they have an understanding why our company was founded in 2005. So it starts with the interview of my grandmother, and it ends with the people that Art is working with right now within the Van Aert Group. It's a great read, I have to say. The writers did a great job. This book is available during our network event, so we brought a couple of books from the Netherlands. It's available at the network event at the end of the day. So if you join, please let me know. If you can't join, send me an email or anybody of our teams, and we will make sure that you get also a copy of it. And after you read this book, then you also have to read this book. So this is our 10-year anniversary book. It came out at the end of last year. And this describes, not by ourselves, but from our the people that work for us, our partners, our clients, well, everybody that is connected to our organization, they are being interviewed and they tell their story about our company, how they have experienced working with us, for us, together with us. So all kinds of different interviews, but it gives you a good view on understanding of who we are as a company. Also, this book is available. So if you can join our event at the end of the day, take one with you. If you can't join, let us know, and you want to receive the book, let us know, and we will take care of the fact that you will receive a book like this. Well, the last thing I would like to say again, it's been said many times already, well, thank you. Thank you for everything so far, and we're going to make a huge success of our company here in the Gainesville community. I'm really looking forward to it. Thank you.